So the last 48 hours have been a very emotional one for Nigerians and Africans generally. We've seen a lot of footage coming out of South Africa where a lot of people have been attacked, their businesses have been destroyed, and in instances lives have been lost and injuries sustained to varying degrees by different people. And the primary reason the attackers are given for their behavior is that foreigners, black Africans like themselves, have come to their country and are taking away their opportunities like jobs and what have you. And there are so many strains to the conversation, but one of the most painful things that has happened is the reprisal attacks by Nigerians on supposedly South African businesses. A lot has been said already about how many of those businesses are really just franchises, and ultimately in destroying them we are just hurting our fellow Nigerians. So I personally condemn the attacks strongly, but I'm quite happy about some of the measures that have been taken by the federal government. So pulling out of the World Economic Forum that's going on in South Africa is a very bold step. I think the South African government should sit up and take really strong actions to fix this problem. I think part of the reason this has been going on over the years is for political reasons. Maybe someone with more information can share what they know, but this is my own personal take on the matter, and that is the fact that the South African government and ruling party have refused to do anything concrete to stop the xenophobic attacks that have been going on by South Africans, because they are scared of losing votes at elections. And so when people go on the streets and carry out these acts of destruction, no consequence, no, or at least nothing that we hear of. And so they go on and on and on, you know, and continue killing and destroying people. It's a sad situation. I want to hope that in addition to the statements the Nigerian government have made, they will take serious measures to protect the South African businesses in Nigeria. The reality is a lot of Nigerians are angry and are looking for opportunities to vent. That is why they have gone to attack those places. So it's a sad thing that they've done, really bad. And the government needs to provide adequate protection for these companies and these businesses. But the reality is, underneath all of this, there's a lot of work that needs to be done around alleviating poverty and making sure that people are gainfully employed or involved in things that are going to be of economic benefit to them. Because when you're busy making money, and I'm talking about money, you're not going to be worried about things like, he took my job, she took my job. You know, all that would not be a concern. But when you're hungry, you know, some one of the videos that was circulating, I heard somebody talking about food as they were going into the shop, right? And I was saying, this is a clear indication of how the fact that people are hungry is leading them to think with their stomachs and not with their heads. Because the reality is, like someone also said, you know, if you take, say, a tin of jam or food, how long is that going to last you or even solve your problems? It can't. You know, so the real problem is fixing poverty, you know, creating employment, and getting people, you know, involved in a whole growth trajectory, you know, that improves and betters their lives. And for my South African brothers and sisters, I think you guys who are involved in these xenophobic attacks need to have a rethink about what you are doing. It's wrong. I'm also not going to advocate for you to go and attack any whites. That's wrong. I've seen a lot of information saying whites own 80 or 85% of the economy in South Africa, the land and all of that. So why are we attacking fellow blacks? To me, that is an indirect endorsement of an attack on whites. And I'm saying we shouldn't be attacking anybody. The government in South Africa also needs to make sure it's empowering its people so that they also grow. I kind of feel, because I've read some literature on South Africa, I feel maybe the country has never ever really fully recovered from apartheid. Here's what I mean. So in the build-up to the release of Nelson Mandela, and then also after he got out of prison and then contested for elections, a lot of violence happened in South Africa, you know. And so I feel the people moved from black on white violence resisting apartheid to black on black violence, because now they were trying to, you know, position themselves to be in charge of the resources of the country as the leaders of the country. And there was a lot of infighting among who should lead, who should represent the black community and all of that, you know. So I'm not sure that the country has fully recovered, you know, from apartheid, but the anger has been channeled to other people. So now it's no longer channeled at the whites, who were the ones, you know, that had the apartheid regime going. It's no longer channeled at their fellow South Africans with whom they were fighting to decide who would control the country economically, politically, and what have you. It is now channeled at foreigners who they think, black foreigners, who they think have come to take the few opportunities that they have. You know, and what it means is a lot of work needs to be done to create more equality in the system. I'm talking about the South African system, so that people are getting the benefits of being in the system. Yeah? And that way, there will be less anger to channel around. You know, so that is my take on the matter. I could be wrong, but I mean, I'm open to corrections from anybody who knows better. I think generally in Africa, things are bad. We know that economically, in terms of healthcare, education, infrastructure. Of course, there's been an improvement across the board to varying degrees from country to country. But by and large, you can see that the generality of people are hungry. People are not getting good health care. And, you know, people are just unhappy, you know. So, and the reason they're unhappy is because of things that should be simple, you know, to fix. Africa is resource rich, you know, but we're still living in terrible conditions. You know, if you think about a country like Nigeria, you have to provide your own power, you know, because power supply is inconsistent. You have to, in some cases, provide your own water, so people dig boreholes in their houses or rely on wells. You have to provide your own security. You have to provide practically everything, you know, and the resources are not readily available, you know. So, and then you see people driving around in flashy cars. You know, for instance, politicians who were recently elected this year, the legislature to be in particular, are talking about buying new vehicles. That's going to cost us billions, you know. And some analysis has been done about what they earn and compared it to what legislators earn all across the world. You know, and when you compare what our GDP per capita is to what we are earning, it's lower than what other countries in the developed world are earning, and yet their legislators and politicians earn less than our politicians do. So how are we able to sustain that? You know, it's deeper than what it seems to be, this whole thing. So the guys in South Africa who are doing all of this are unhappy. You know, they feel cheated, and they're just looking for soft targets to whom they can channel their anger. Similar thing in Nigeria for those ones who went ahead to attack and reprisal attacks. The government really need to do a lot to fix all these problems. And I'm going to encourage everybody to just remain calm, try not to get involved in anything dangerous. And I'm not just talking about physically, even encouraging people to go and, you know, attack and do anything that would endanger another human being. That's totally wrong. The steps Nigerian government has taken so far are great. I like the fact that they've pulled out of the WF engagements going on there, and also they promised to call the ambassador back to ask him questions and better understand what exactly is going on. We need to provide a lot more security for our people, and also for the businesses who are here in Nigeria, and make sure nobody gets injured and no businesses are damaged. And everybody who has been involved in any kind of attack in Nigeria or South Africa should face the full wrath of the law.